Celestron just recently dropped their 2-port and their 4-port Dew controllers and their Dew heater rings for Schmidt cast grains. Now, before we get into all of this, we want to make a quick announcement and let you guys know that every video that we produce in the month of February is all about how you can improve your astrophotos, whether it be through post-processing videos or quick tips and hint or trick videos, or even product review videos like this one over products that we think may allow you to gather better data and just have a better time out in the field. So first things first, let's unbox the Dew heater and see what's inside. First is the manual, or a set of instructions. If there is by any chance something that we forgot to mention in this video, or maybe you have questions, please consult the instruction manual. It is very thorough, it is very well written, and it's one of the things that we love so much about Celestron. Next, we have the Celestron Dew controller itself. On this thing, it has 9 ports. The first 2 ports are Dew heater ports. You also have a 12 volt input. You have 2 sensor ports, and on the other side, you have 2 auxiliary ports, a USB 2.0 port, and a 12 volt output.
12 volt
output port. The Dew controller comes with several cables, the first one being a 12 volt DC power cable. You'll simply power your Dew controller with this cable. You'll plug the barrel jack into the 12 volt input on the Dew controller, and then you'll plug the DC port into a battery or an AC-DC adapter. Next up is the auxiliary cable. You plug this into the auxiliary port on the Dew controller and then into your mount, and this is going to allow you to control the Dew controller from your mount's hand controller. Next, we have a standard barrel jack to barrel jack 5.5 by 2.1 millimeter power cable, and this is used to power your mount or any other accessory from the Dew controller itself via the
12 volt
output port. Next, we have the thermistor cable, and this is responsible for environmental readings such as temperature, humidity, and dew point. You want to plug this directly into the sensor port on your Dew controller. Now let's take a look at what comes with the Celestron 8-inch Dew heater ring. First up is another very precisely well-written set of instructions on how to install this. We will go over that later in the video. Next piece up is the RCA cable. This attaches your Dew heater ring to the Dew controller itself. Next is a nice little clip that goes onto the rim of your Schmidt cast grain for cable management. And finally, we have the Dew ring itself with a thermistor port and a RCA port. And it also comes along with a nice paper ring to put over your corrected plate so you don't scratch it up or get fingerprints on it during installation process. Now let's go install the dang thing. When installing the Dew heater ring, first you want to point your telescope 90 degrees upwards and add the paper installation piece onto your corrector plate. Next, you want to use a screwdriver to remove the screws from the original retaining ring. Be sure that when you are removing the screws or removing the retaining ring, you do not rotate the corrector plate. You want to do this delicately because any change in orientation of the corrector plate is going to create astigmatisms, and this is going to be pretty difficult to correct, so please be careful when doing this procedure. Next, you want to correctly replace and orient the Dew heater ring. Make sure the notches match. When you reinstall the screws, install the screws finger tight and then tighten with the screwdriver in a cross pattern. So after this, your Dew heater ring should be correctly installed. So there are actually 2 ways that you can power up your Celestron Dew heater ring itself. Firstly, we're going to explain the easy way. You can attach your AC adapter directly to the ring itself for power. It will, however, operate at 100%. The power is either on or off. This is best used for quick sessions outside with minimal equipment, especially great for visual observing sessions. Now, the addition of the thermistor cable is going to significantly improve the efficiency of your Dew heater and your Dew heater controller. So if you are in the field using a battery and you need to save as much power as possible, we highly recommend you use the thermistor cable and the full setup, which we will be discussing here in a minute. Let's go ahead and set everything up. After installing your Dew heater ring to your Schmidt cast grain, first you want to strap the Dew heater around the tripod leg. You do have the option of attaching it to a Vixen or a Celestron CGE style dovetail, but since I have the Nexstar 8SC, having it here on the tripod is going to reduce vibration. First, you want to connect your thermistor cable to the Dew heater ring and then to the Dew controller. After that, attach your RCA cable to the Dew heater ring and also back to the Dew heater port 1 on the controller. Next, you want to attach the auxiliary cable to the Dew controller and then to your mount. This is going to allow us to control the Dew heater from our hand controller. Celestron even left an extra auxiliary port for a SkyPortal Wi-Fi dongle. Now we're going to connect the included 5.5mm by 2.1mm barrel-to-barrel power cable to our Dew controller and then into your mount's 12-volt input. If you do choose to control your Dew heater from your hand controller, you need to make sure that your firmware is up to date. For my Nexstar hand controller, I need firmware version 5.33.133 or greater. Now here in a moment, we will discuss how to use Celestron's PWI software to control the Dew heater, but first we're going to go through the hand controller settings and show you how to control the Dew heater from our hand controller. So within the hand controller's Dew heater option, you have four additional options. By selecting input power, this will allow you to monitor the power draw from the devices connected to your Dew controller. You can check input current from the power source and you can set the maximum current draw. Secondly, if you hit the Dew heater port menu and you do not want to use the automatic smart control, then this is where you will adjust your settings. By changing your hand controller to manual mode, you now have to specify a desired power level from 0 to 100%. In auto mode, you will need to adjust aggressiveness or how active the Dew heater will be in preventing dew. Now, we recommend you set this aggressiveness higher in colder or humid climates and lower in drier or windier climates. If you're not very sure, go ahead and set it to a 5 out of 10 for starter. The next menu option is power ports. This allows you to monitor any 12-volt DC device connected to the power output port. You have the ability to disable and re-enable power to this device at any time. Finally, we have the environmental port, and here is where you can view ambient temperature, humidity levels, and dew points. If you would like to recalibrate your Dew controller, you can do that under the recalibration settings. Now, recalibrating your Dew controller system isn't necessary most of the time. If you haven't taken your Dew controller out for a long time, or it's been sitting in a box or in storage for a while, then we recommend you do a recalibration process at the beginning of your observing or imaging session. I did mention that if you are imaging out in the field with your laptop, you may want to use Celestron's PWI software to control your Dew heater system. It's going to allow you to adjust all of the settings that your hand controller will, and it will actually provide you with a lot more visual feedback. To connect your Dew controller to your laptop, you'll need a USB 2.0 cable, which is actually not supplied. Within the CPWI software, you will be provided with several windows, the first one being a Dew heater overview window, which will provide you with nearly all of the information about your current system you are running. They also provide you with a power graph, which shows you power usage over time for all devices connected to your Dew controller. CPWI provides you with an awesome environment graph, which shows you ambient air temperature, humidity, and calculated dew points over time. And finally, you have the Dew heater settings window where you can adjust maximum current among many other settings. Now, like I mentioned earlier, if you are running a full imaging system outside and you are already using a laptop, you may as well use the Celestron PWI software. We think it's going to be the most convenient way to go. Okay, so that is it for our Celestron Dew Controller product review, along with the 8-inch Dew heater ring for Schmidt-Cassegrain telescopes. We really hope you enjoyed, and we say thank you for tuning in. Again, our entire video series in February is going to be about how you can improve your astrophotos. So if you live in a humid climate, like I do, using a Dew heater ring is going to be a great way to start. That being said, if you have any questions or comments, please let us know in the comment section below. Be sure to like our video, subscribe to our YouTube channel so you don't miss any of our future content. We thank you so much, and clear skies.